perform these acts were those recruiters questioned by authorities under oath or, you know, facing potential false statements if they lied to the FBI? Were they questioned by the authorities?
They were questioned by the Palm Beach Police Department. In fact, the arrest records that I have mostly are arrest records that belong to Haley Robson, Sarah Kellen, who has recently changed her name to Kensington. Ghislaine Maxwell was never questioned by the police. And Adriana Ross. Those, and Nadia Marcinkova. Those four procurers who are named in the current indictment.
The new indictment.
And they are named and identified in the New York indictment. Those four girls were the principal procurers at the time. And they would procure them by...
And what, I mean, why weren't they charged at the time as well? Or did they...
That was part of the
deny
deal.
That they were
Haley Robson, in fact, called herself to the police the Palm Beach Heidi Fleiss. She self-identified as the Palm Beach Heidi Fleiss.
Well, you know, a big reason that we're talking about this now is obviously because of this new indictment in the Southern District of New York, but also because of all the controversy around so-called non-prosecution agreement with Alex Acosta, the current Labor Secretary in the Trump administration, and his office with his U.S. attorney negotiated. And we just listened to him give a press conference in which he was asked the question about...
This might be the last water, so...
And he said, well, their focus was on Epstein, but I don't see that these... two things are mutually exclusive. Did Michael Reiter, did the local Palm Beach police, did they want to pursue